Let's spend a few minutes talking about my dovetail saw. If you are just getting started or looking to improve your dovetails, I cannot stress enough how important the saw you choose will be to the end result. I'm often quoted as saying that the saw accounts for 70% of the success of your joint, and I'm going to explain that. But first, I want to show you some of the options. This is how the saw comes. The first thing you notice when you pick it up is the weight of it, and that's on purpose, by design. Now, I'm going to give you some options first, and we'll focus on the saw. It comes standard with a black composite handle. You have the option of getting a bone composite handle, which, by the way, is about 15% heavier than the black. White oak is also a standard option. This is in the partially finished state. Or, what's really pretty, is this fiddleback maple. This also is an option. And then we have several others that you can check out on the site that I do on a one-off basis. Now, for those who have a really large hand, I wear a large glove, and this fits me very comfortably. But if you've got a really large hand, we actually offer an upsized version, and I'll put the two together so that you can see how much larger it is. I should turn it over that way. Okay? So this is really too big for my hand, but if, like I said, you get a large paw, this may be your best bet. All right, let's focus on the saw. You have the blade is 10 inches long. You've got an inch and 5/8 depth of cut. The blade itself is 20 thousandths of an inch, and there's just 2 thousandths of an inch set per side. And I'm going to explain set a little more in detail. That means you're going to get a saw curve that's 24 thousandths of an inch. And in relative terms, a piece of writing paper is 4 thousandths of an inch thick. So that means that the set is just half the thickness of a piece of paper on either side. Now the 22-15 is what catches most people's attention. What that stands for is 22 teeth, or TPI, teeth per inch, and then the rest of the saw is actually 15 TPI, a larger tooth. And these are all rip teeth because we are ripping wood when cutting a dovetail. We're not cutting across the grain, we're cutting parallel or near parallel to it. Now, these first 2 inches at 22 teeth per inch also have a negative 30 degree cutting angle. That means it's very relaxed, easy to start. The balance of the saw has 15 teeth per inch with a 0 degree cutting face, which makes it very aggressive, very fast cutting. Let me just demonstrate that. If you can't start your saw accurately, it doesn't matter how smooth or how fast it cuts, you're gonna have to carve the thing out anyway. The ability to go in and start precisely is what is really the make or break in this joint. Here's how I do it. I create an anchor point with my index finger and thumb. I press the saw laterally, and I'm always pressing laterally to avoid the skirting the saw might do either to the left or to the right when I first get started. Using the little teeth, and by the way, this is a three-finger open pistol grip, that's why the three-finger recesses, and you hold it very lightly, kind of like you would holding a baby's hand. Press the saw against the fingers, just use the first couple of inches, and this is all you want to do, just enough to catch your thumb. And once you do that, you then move to the big teeth in the back, and there's where you get your speed. And this cuts fast enough that you'll actually end up blowing by your line if you're not careful. Now when I cut the opposite way, I have to move my thumb out, use my index finger, again press laterally, use the first couple of inches to get it started, and then proceed with the big teeth, and there's your speed. Now, the saw will cut laser straight, and that's because it tracks. Very narrow set allows for that. The disadvantage, if you want to call it that, is you can't make a correction partway through. But you'd never want to do that anyway. I'll tell you why. A straight cut equals a flat surface. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to come in here about 3/4 inch, and I'm going to make a cut as deep as the saw will allow. By the way, if you keep your board low in the vise, hold it very firmly, and you're not going to get that vibration that would happen when you're cutting up here. Then I'm going to come in, I'm going to remove that piece. Now, in order to get a good joint, you need two flat surfaces that are nice and smooth, and that's what's produced. So when I take these two pieces and put them back together, you'll see how nice of a glue joint, whether we spin it around. Now, when you cut the side of your pin and the side of your tail and you put them together, you get that perfect glue joint. That's what it's all about. That's why it's 70% of your ability to cut the joint. If you've got to come in and take a chisel and try to create that, your chance of success really start to nosedive. This is the saw that will allow you in the first week to get to a point where you can do a dovetail joint that you never would have thought possible. This is the best saw out there. I've tried many saws. I've been doing this for a long time. I finally got frustrated in not being able to find a saw that had the proper set that actually had rip teeth, so I ended up making my own. I made it and designed it based around my ability to cut the joint and, more importantly to you, my ability to teach others how to do this. This will be the only saw you'll ever need. We manufacture them right here. We do the entire process. We've actually been making them for 10 years, and we'd be happy to send you one. If you're looking to get dovetails and to get it done right, get the saw, get started, and you won't look back.